welcome to the Lair of Legless Legends. I'm Scarlet Nightshade, and today we're going to be covering the top 5 most legendary colubrid snakes. Colubrids are the largest family of snakes and include species such as corn snakes, milk snakes, and king snakes. With over 200 genera, there is a massive amount of variation between species, making this family of slithery legends especially fascinating. First up on our list is Drymarkin, also known as Creebos and Indigos. While there are a few different species of Creebos and Indigos, we're going to be talking specifically about the Eastern Indigo and the Black-tailed Creebo. The most notable aspect of this species is that they are incredibly intelligent and very inquisitive. Drymarkin are very large-bodied, powerful snakes, with the Eastern Indigo actually being the longest snake native to the United States. Both Eastern Indigos and Black-tailed Creebos have the potential to reach up to 7 to 8 feet. Interestingly, male Drymarkin tend to be bulkier than the females, especially when comparing head size. Drymarkin exhibit stunning coloration. Eastern Indigos are best known for their beautiful ebony scales, often in contrast with the deep, crimson-red throat. On the other hand, Black-tailed Creebos exhibit a bronze coloration, which gradually peppers into the solid black tail they're most renowned for. One fascinating fact unique to this species is that they are not constrictors, nor are they venomous. Instead, Drymarkin rely on their remarkably powerful bite force to literally chomp their prey to death. With live prey, it isn't uncommon for them to forego the chomping action and just skip to devouring their prey alive. Creebos and Indigos enjoy a large variety of prey items, with their diet consisting primarily of snakes in the wild. In captivity, dietary variety can be provided by offering rodents, chicks, quail, frogs, and, if acquired from trusted sources, reptilian prey. I would like to add a disclaimer that while all prey items have the potential to carry communicable parasites and disease, reptilian prey does pose the highest risk of disease transmission and should only be acquired from trusted sources, as previously mentioned. Number 2 on our list is Hydrodynastis gigas, or the false water cobra. False water cobras are another exceptionally intelligent species that exhibits more curious behaviors than any other snake I've kept. As their name implies, they have partially mastered the skill of mimicry, in which they will flare their hoods as part of their threat display. However, unlike the elapids they aim to imitate, false water cobras do not typically position themselves vertically while flaunting their hood of lies. Without this ability, their attempts at intimidation are futile. They honestly just look very confused in how they're supposed to utilize the threatening hood they've been gifted. Another unique characteristic of this species is that they're rear-fanged venomous, which means they possess tiny little fangs that are fixed at the rear of their mouth. False water cobra venom is composed of comparatively mild toxins, which are secreted from a specialized oral gland called the Duvernoy's gland. However, the venom delivery system of rear-fanged venomous colubrids is quite poor and unimpressive in comparison to the more advanced front-fanged venomous species. In order for these snakes to even begin to envenomate their prey, they must chew them into the rear of their mouth, a process formerly known as the pterygoid walk. That said, one of the most enjoyable aspects of keeping false water cobras is feeding them. They have a very intense feeding response, especially as eager juveniles. Like Drymarkin, they will also feast upon a variety of prey items, which include chicks, quail, and frogs on top of standard rodents. The morphology of false water cobras is still being discovered, but there are a few confirmed color mutations, such as lavender and hypomelanistic. Overall, this species is definitely one of my favorites. In fact, one of my most precious companions was a false water cobra named Legion. Unfortunately, Legion passed away recently from liver failure, which is why I've been a bit more absent lately. Losing Legion was extremely difficult for me, and I needed time to grieve. But Legion was a pinnacle of the species, and he is a perfect example of how much these animals can really impact our lives. Third on our list is Bogartophis subocularis, also known as the Transpacos rat snake. First and foremost, they have big, beautiful eyes. Transpacos are a stunning species with similar care requirements as corn snakes, although they are more rare in the hobby. This species is exceptionally docile, even as juveniles. Bites, musking, and flighty behaviors are actually pretty uncommon for Transpacos. They're typically very methodical and easy to handle. These are also very curious snakes that seem to appreciate being offered climbing enrichment as well as slightly elevated hides. And did I mention their big, beautiful eyes? Number 4 on our list is going to be Thamnophis sertalis infernalis, or the California red-sided garter snake. While there are several garter snake species, the California red-sided garter snake is by far one of the most colorful. And not just among garter snakes, but among all snakes on the planet. That said, their beauty does come with a minor price. They can be pretty nuts, especially as juveniles. And while they do grow out of the biting and musking stage as they approach adulthood, you may have to deal with a tiny, musky, flighty monster for the first few years. But at least they're colorful. California red-sided garter snakes are very easy to care for, although they do have a notably interesting diet. Common prey items include earthworms, small fish, amphibians, slugs, and other small critters as well as standard rodents. Neonates are quite tiny, and they're often started on cut-up earthworms and mouse tails until they're large enough to consume whole prey. They also somehow manage to display what I call an aggressive tongue-flicking behavior. I can't quite explain to you how or why their tongue-flicking comes off as aggressive, but if you take a peek at this video, you can just see how threatening this fella is trying to be with his tongue flicks. I mean, it isn't intimidating in the slightest, but he's trying his best. And finally, number 5 on our list is Lampropeltis getula, also known as king snakes. While more common than the other species on our top 5, king snakes are one of the most iconic snake species that ever existed in the hobby, and they deserve a spot on the list. To narrow it down a bit, I'm going to be covering a few of the most commonly kept king snake species, which will include the Mexican black king snake, Florida king snake, and California king snake. I'd like to start off by saying our career as snake breeders actually began with a Mexican black king snake named Apophis. He is one of the most special snakes we have here, although he is known for having a gambling problem. While king snake demeanor can vary greatly between individuals, some of my most calm and gentle snakes are king snakes. While they are known to be more bitey than other common species, they typically develop a very docile personality as they approach adulthood. Others, well, they may not be too bright like Checkers here. He's not stressed or suffering in any way, but his insatiable appetite makes him eat things that really shouldn't be eating like himself. But we still love him, even when he tries to eat our shoelaces. Anyhow, regarding size, king snakes can vary a bit between species. Although most commonly kept king snakes typically average a little over 4 foot, with some having the potential to reach up to 6 foot. Apophis, our Mexican black king snake with a gambling problem, is quite large at just short of 6 foot. In terms of color mutations, there are far too many for me to cover, but you can find a king snake in just about every color imaginable. One of our favorite king snakes, Alun, has a combination of the white-sided and ghost genetics, and the combination of these two traits give her a beautiful snowy white appearance. She also is equipped with a sweet personality and a ravenous appetite. But then again, I think the best souls share the same characteristics. Well, that sums up our top 5 legendary colubrid snakes. If you enjoyed learning about these amazing animals, please give this video a like and be sure to hit the subscribe button for more slithery content. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you again in the lair of Legless Legends.